I don't think this is set up correctly. Let's see.
We're there. We are live.
Are we live? It's not showing me anything here.
I can see it where my button says live. Okay. There you are.
Redirecting. Okay, so give us a minute. This is Brenda Edelman and Martin Lopez on my side. Of course, I'm not seeing it, but let's go back to Zoom and I will just, for whatever reason, my face. Here we go. I can at least see myself here. I do not have it on my Facebook yet. It's the weirdest thing. Okay. You see it, right?
Yeah, I'm actually moving it around. So yeah, okay. I'm going to share it on my...
I don't see it. Okay. Hi, everybody. This is Brenda Edelman, your on video presentation coach. And I am with my friend, my colleague, and my client, Martin Lopez, who is creating his new online course this weekend. And just so happens to turn out that I am leading a beta version of a very new program called Your Virtual Video Weekend Retreat. And he's joining me and us in there because it's all about video. It's all about making your videos better, using them in your online courses, using them for your website, using them to send out to your email list, using them to do Facebook Lives, like so that you're comfortable, you're confident, you're authentic. And the last two days, I've been kind of interviewing him and teaching him really radical skills on how to up his game. Also using acting trips. You use acting tips, like improv, knowing how to correct yourself in the moment. Because a lot of people are afraid to do live streams because they're like, oh my God, I'm gonna mess up. Believe me, it's okay. What's not okay, and this is something I learned from being an actress for so many years, what's not okay is messing up and then staying in your head and not being right back in the moment and connecting with people. So that's what I'll be teaching you over the weekend. So there was something I wanted to say. Oh, just to start, this is driving me crazy that I can't see it on my Facebook, but that's okay. I trust.
It's there, I promise.
What are the two? How about this? Because we talked for the last couple of days. What do you think are the two biggest, and he's gone. Well, we've gone over like what he should wear, what the background should be, how to present to be exciting. What do you think the top two or three things that you learned are the last 2 days? Because there were so many, but like that can make a significant difference in how you're going to move forward on video.
Well, for sure, the thing that I'm really focused on is the different the ways of acting. So the different ways of acting. So I have three different personalities that I speak to, and I've been practicing those. So when I'm talking, you know, when I'm using something like I'm talking to my father, it's kind of more like that. And then if I'm talking to, so then I'm a jazz musician, so I talk to the crowds. Hey guys, how you doing, man? Just, you know, it's kind of like more kind of pepping up. And then when I talk to my kids or my dog, you know, it's just like kind of reach in and say, hey guys.
I'm adding you to the timeline because for whatever reason, it wasn't on my page, but now.
So it's those, yeah. That's the big nuggets that I've been getting at, and I've been practicing that. So I actually been practicing that as I've been making phone calls because every day in my mortgage business, I make phone calls. So I was literally making phone calls with kind of different personalities. It was funny.
How fun is that though? Yeah. I'm so glad. So it's still not up on my Facebook. I am just giving it over to Spirit right now and to Martin because he sees it. since we're all one, this is so exciting to me because for those of you who have no idea what the hell he's talking about, go to day one and day two, which is on my page, Brenda Edelman, because I go into details. I show him how to do this. They're acting tips. This is what most teachers who are teaching video don't give you because they just don't come from it's often entrepreneurs that don't necessarily come from the acting perspective or from teaching acting, which I've been doing for so many years as well. So it's basically going above and beyond just picking, and this is new information for some people, to like think of someone you love right behind the camera. Look how different it is. You'll be able to see. Like I was just talking to Martin, who I love in one way, but I'm also looking at him, so my eyes are not at the lens. But now let me think of someone really that I love, and I'm going to look at them very differently. And I'm not saying you stay there the whole time, or maybe you do, but it's getting really conscious of what you're doing so that if you want to grab someone in, maybe even just at the top of your videos, you're going to talk directly to the lens. I know some people say, don't ever look at the person, always look at the lens. I disagree with that, actually, because if you're not trained, like as an actor, where we are literally doing like close-ups, like a love scene with a close-up and you're not even seeing anybody there, it's in your mind's eye. If you're not trained, you might get into your head. So what I say is, yes, start with the lens, then go talk to the person you're talking to so that you see them, there's a connection, and then just keep remembering to bring your eyes up. But you don't have to do it the whole time. I've done like over 150 interviews. They came out great, and that's what I do. I always remember, and then I look back up at the lens, but I like really connecting with people. And of course, if you arrange it so that the video, the other person is pretty close to the camera, that works. So beyond just having that one person, I suggest having more than one person, which is what he was talking about, your father or another character. You're going to talk differently to them. So we'll use the lover in front of me, and then we'll use my son when he was young, and I'm gonna like let's say I place him there. It doesn't mean you always have to look to the side when you're talking to him.
How about, can you do it with us, like do three?
Yes,
like,
what I'm saying, I'm gonna do it all okay. To you.
Okay, cool.
But sometimes this will help you, so that's
what helped me. Yeah.
Yeah, like it helps you to place them in different places at first so that you kind of get it into your body. But so here I'm talking to my lover. Oh, I am so happy that you are here today. Literally, that makes sense for me inviting my audience in, if they don't know that that's who I'm thinking about. And then if I was talking to my son, which I just said, it would be, I am so glad that you're here today. You know, if I'm talking to, all right, this is going to be playing opposite. So it's probably not what you do in your business, but who knows, if you're a tough ass, hard ass, you know, trying to get a point across, it might be me thinking of someone I'm mad at. And it's like, I'm so glad you're here today. That could actually work for a business thing of like, for let's say your audience doesn't show up for themselves and you're like playing with them for a minute. Like, I'm so glad you're here today. Or you using some kind of self-deprecating humor. I'm so glad you're here today. Like me, freaking put my contacts in, did something with my hair, not much, obviously. You know what I'm saying? Like, it brings another kind of personality. I'm going to do a side note on the hair for a second, since my hair seems to be like a character in my videos. It is raining, cats and dogs. I don't even know that expression, but what that means. But it is raining so hard here in San Diego.
Got to watch a Monty Python movie to understand what that means.
Oh, is it from Monty Python?
No, but there's one of the movies where they do it.
That's so funny. Anyway, for those of us who are curly haired girls or whatever, just know that it's just one of the things we use to not show up for ourselves. Just like people use, I'm too heavy, I'm too old, I'm too young, I don't look good. My hair does not look great today. And I didn't have time to zhuzh it up. But I zhuzhed it a little. It might not look like it. I did put a little bit of oil in it. But what I'm saying is show up. This weekend, I will tell you, when we're working together, all the tips and tricks you can use to help you for where you are. But show up for yourself, no matter what, even if your hair isn't perfect, even if you feel like, shit, with this isolation, I'm not working out, I've gained 10 pounds, 15 pounds, I'll just talk for myself. You know, just like be kind to yourself and show up, because your message is really important. Your business is really important. Entrepreneurs, we're the ones who will actually really help keep this economy going right now and keep your own personal economy going, right? So that's also the reason I decided, like in a, you know, kind of a brain download I got to do this weekend workshop, because I do have a do-it-yourself program called You on Video, which is very comprehensive. But the people who get the biggest results are always the ones who work with me. And so, because quickly, like look how much stuff we worked on the last 2 days. Quickly, I can tell where you can I can give you a hint or a tip or some guidance, and your growth will be like night and day. Where you didn't know how to do something, you'll know how to do it, and you'll be confident therefore, and you'll be out there more, keeping your economy okay, right? So I was like, let me do this weekend intensive where I give you my program at like 80% off, And I'm also there to help critique your videos. So that's what that is. And let me pull that up real quickly, because on the other videos, I pulled it up at the end. So let's do
I put the link in. So as you're looking at that, I'd like to say something. So one of the things that happens when you do one-on-one training, you go into a course, the thing that happens is that you might not focus on the number one thing that you want to work on. Because I didn't, and sometimes you don't even know what that number one thing is. So what happened for me is there were things I wanted to work on. And then what we ended up working on ended up building a foundation for all the other things I want to work on. And now I'm excited about this weekend, about taking the class, because I was able to work on, this is going to be the third class I'm going to do with you, Brenda. And tomorrow it's going to build onto that. I know it's going to do, I know it's just going to keep building. So I'm excited about that.
Yeah, it's so great. So the first three people who join, and you'll be one of those, is getting a 30-minute one-on-one with me as well. And I spoke with someone last night who's probably going to get that third spot. So we'll also be refining it even more. But I will be giving feedback on three videos right inside the group. And what I'm excited about with you is that you're working on your new program. So that means, because this is your words, these are your words. You were like, on video, I look at it and I'm just like, bleh.
Exactly.
I know, yeah. I can do better. So how many of you watching this are like, I really know I can do better, but you don't know how because you don't have the tools. So basically what you can do with this, so you're not putting hours and hours into videos that are just kind of blah,
yeah,
and boring. And certainly people can make videos that are just kind of blah, but why would you now that you got the secret weapon? You can bring like the first 5 minutes you do already based on all this foundation I've given you, and also all the foundation that's in the program that you'll get access to. As soon as anyone signs up, they get access to that. And then you bring your first one, you're already like steps ahead of where you were because you're looking at my training, and then I give you very specific feedback, and then you're like off and running. Just like when people are writing books, if you get the edited, you know, you get the editing back, because I also critique on that. You get the editing back and you know, oh, my sentence structure is incorrect. Oh, I can see how those words would be better. Oh, I'm putting too many adjectives in. And then your writing going forward is better. It's the same thing with video. I show you where I see it could be better, and then right away you're implementing it to the rest of your course, and it's just better from the beginning.
Yeah, I love that. That's that. Yeah, absolutely. And for me, what happened and why I came to you was because, like you said, I felt like every time I do a video, like I can do this right now and I can have energy because it's you talking. I'm engaged. It's you know, I'm in flow because I'm live and I gotta be on. There's just something mentally that I have, like, it's not a block, but it's not training that I have when I put a camera in front of me and then I got to be on. I wanted more personality, and I don't have very much personality when it comes to recording my video.
Which is shocking because you have so much personality, but that's like a lot of people. You have so much, you know, the reason I started teaching this video, like I mentioned, is that I have all these colleagues. So I come from an acting background, but I have all these colleagues who are coaches, consultants, healers, fabulous experts in what they do, just oozing personality. And then I would see them get on video and then on live stream, and I'd be like, I would click away because I was so bored. And I'm like, I gotta help them. Like, they need to be themselves on video. So that's what you'll learn. That's what.
Yeah, I'm bored to watch me too. I did a three-step guide to home buying video, and it was just like so boring. I was just like looking at myself and going, and not to be critical, but I would click away from me.
I personally think it's good to be critical because that's how I learned how to be the killer actress I am. I learned that I had to be willing to be bad. And so that's one thing I want to say about this virtual weekend. It's about be bad, be too much. I'd rather you be too much than too little, because we tend to be too little always, right? Yeah. So that's why we get boring. It's like, I want you to come in and bring everything. Like, I might give you it's very specific to everybody there, but I might give someone a character exercise to work on where it's so much friggin' fun, but it takes them out of their comfort zone so that then they can bring it back. Like, you know, for the camera, because the camera, it's also very specific platform. So like something where I'd be so big on stage, it might not be appropriate, but I might be like this instead. Like, there's very specific techniques I'm going to be teaching you in there. So exciting. Okay. Let me just see what else is on here. The page is on there. Okay. So it starts. So you get my program, which is $600. You on video. I can post a link somewhere. I think on the sales page here, there's a link to check out that program, everything that's in there, because you're going to learn backgrounds, what's put in the background, how to do the setup, what colors to wear, I on purpose wore different colors each day of these videos, and so did you. And I'll give you a little critique on that afterwards. What to put in your set, how to express yourself so that your energy comes through, how to make your presentation interesting so people are compelled, what to say, do you use a script, do you improvise? Like, that's all in that program. Then you're going to be able to put three videos inside our private group, and I'm going to give you 3 to 5 notes on each of those so that you know, we'll decide on the first call when you should post your first one. I'll probably give you specific assignments. Then you'll post your first video, whatever you want, a welcome video. You want to do a live stream in there that you want to comment on, which is great because it's just getting those nerves. And I can actually comment on, like, for those of you who haven't done live streams, I can comment on how to help you with your nerves if that's the thing, because nobody else is going to be seeing it. If you're wanting to do a course, you put it in there. 3 of those, you'll get, you could potentially have one really polished video this weekend. And we're also meeting 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time on Saturday and Sunday so that we can get together for community, for creativity, for connection. I'm sure I'll say and keep the whole weekend in some kind of prayer, depending on how prayerful people are. I will have a state of prayer for everybody at this time, knowing that, you know, we're all doing what we need to do to survive, to thrive, and also let's get centered and know why we're doing everything that we're doing. So that is, you know I have a lot of big energy and I'm passionate and I'm also very prayerful. And I'm also, I don't know if you know this, I'm a trained prayer chaplain for Unity Church. So I used to do that when I lived in Sedona. So it's going to be a very kind of prayerful and playful. Yeah, prayerful and playful place so that you can be your best and you don't have to be afraid to get on video and you can reach your customers, your clients. They need you more than ever. And I've even had people the last few weeks who have never been on video that aren't even using video for business, but they want to look better, feel better, be more interesting when they're on video with their friends, with their colleagues. So you can come in for that. And it's only $97 this weekend. Here's the exciting news. I didn't announce it before. I've decided I'm going to do this again next weekend for $197. It's going to be $197. Anyone who joins this weekend for $97, and they'll get the feedback on those 3 videos, and they get my program, You on Video, forever, not just on the weekend, can join next weekend for free as well. So that means it's $97, and you can literally have 6 videos critiqued by me. I'm so excited about this. So, you know, get in for 97, because as of next weekend, it'll be 197. It'll be for 1 weekend. Right now you can come in for 2, because I haven't had a chance to promote this. So that's why I'm doing that. And I want to reward people who will jump in and get started with me. Okay. So that's that. Okay. Let me get off of screen share. We're going to go into some teaching and preaching.
Teaching and preaching. I love it.
It's so funny.
Some of my friends. So.
Oh, good. It's so funny because when I have a critically acclaimed one woman show that I have performed for all over the world for based on my life story and the power of forgiving the unforgivable. But what I teach my clients, my storytelling clients, and also what I do on stage is I don't preach. I say, don't preach. Just make it your story. So you're not preaching. But in the process of teaching, I might preach a little. Okay.
Awesome.
So we were talking about a couple of things. You wore a different color just before we came on. You wore a different color shirt today.
Today I did, yeah.
Yesterday, two days ago, we critiqued the royal blue that you were wearing in your video that I critiqued, which was a beautiful color on you, but not great for video. This is, in the program, actually, there's a bonus training on like the difference between, I don't think I do it with colors. I do it with presentation style. The difference between telling your story on video versus on stage, because a lot of people want to speak on stage. But that was an example of in person, you look fabulous in the royal blue, but on video with the stark background that you had too, it was too bright. So it took the energy, like people watching would look at your shirt versus your face and your eyes, which is where we want people to be. And then black is perfect color for you. And you wore gray, which I felt yesterday was a light gray, which I felt was good for a casual look. Good with your background because you have the gray in the background as well. But I didn't think it was your best color. at all. I felt like it was a little bit draining. I much prefer this kind of charcoal gray.
Like a charcoal, yeah. That's actually one of my favorite color to wear, actually.
Yeah, I think it's really great. I think it's a great color. Like, even if you stayed with like the blacks and this is great. And then if you wanted to do those, that like, that light gray for your casual posts, like there's all different ways to post. There's ways to do like business posts Monday through Friday and you're wearing that. And then on the weekend, you're wearing these lighter colors. Like there's really fun ways to like enhance your brand.
Yeah. You know what? Last night I did a Facebook Live and I had a black shirt with like blue on the up here. And I didn't really think about that. Now I'm starting to think about that. And I changed really quick. Okay. You know, and I had something else and I put it on. And go, okay. Now I'm not gonna wear that. I'm gonna wear this.
And that's actually what I mean.
I had is I had a black, it was a V-neck. Mm-hmm. And I just said, that doesn't look, it just.
Oh yeah, necklines are important. So I used to work as a personal stylist. I haven't seen you in a V-neck yet, but it's right. Yeah. Some people look great in V's. Some people look great in just the regular t-shirt, the crew neck, yeah. Crew neckline. I'm still forever trying to find my Facebook, but I gotta let it go. Let's see.
I gotta let it go.
Gotta let it go. Let it go. I did want to talk about.
I'll tell you what. Go to my Facebook page.
Well, shouldn't it be on my page?
Yeah, but go to my Facebook page.
Okay.
And then see, look where I read.
Technology. This is what we'll be working on.
Okay. Can you see where I posted it? Click on your name and then it'll take you back to yours and it should take you to where yours
okay, is. I see it on your page. Okay, so now click on my name when it says Brenda's live now.
And it should take you to your page and it should take you to where it's at on your page. I don't know why you can't see it on your page. It's weird.
I do see it. I do see it. Oh, and there's people who wrote comments.
Well, what are the comments? I haven't even seen those.
That's, it's just special pricing. It's your comments.
Oh, there's people, me.
Okay, good. So at least now if someone comes on, I probably should share it from here, but let's see if that drives me nuts. I have a coach who once said, just keep pressing without even looking, you know, to get people on, which is definitely a way to do it. I actually want some people on.
I did that the other day. It's funny. I did that the other day and I invited a whole bunch of people. And then Facebook sent me a notice about 10 o'clock at night and said, we're shutting your ability to talk on, DM or whatever, you know, on Facebook until tomorrow at 12:05 PM or something like that. And if you have a comment, you know, put the comment. And I commented. I said, you know what? I said, Facebook is for connecting. I'm talking about positive connection stuff. And then
it's one of your own videos.
Yeah, on my you know, curiosity theory videos. Was and it was back
were,
on.
Was it because you were inviting people?
Yeah, but I invited a lot of people.
Yeah, but they have the link there for you to invite.
I know. Who knows what those Mark Zuckerberg people do? You know.
Uh-oh.
But they put it back on. They gave it right back to me. So.
Oh, they did? Oh, yeah. Because sometimes also they
no, do it. Just do it. Do it. Do it. You're going to be fine.
No, it stopped. It wouldn't let me. It gave me a few people. You know, Facebook's very odd right now because I did what I just did right now yesterday. And instead of it like popping up as a Facebook, like, oh, you know, when you see someone's on video, it went to people's messenger, which is not what I wanted, which I'm sorry, everybody. I think that's probably what happened to the people I just sent it to right now as well. So now I'm going to stop and just work on the replay so I can be focused with you. So here's a good note. While it's really important to share your videos, if you cannot multitask, just wait, be on with the person and know that most people actually watch the replay. So it's all good. And the algorithms, you never know if Facebook's showing its people or not.
I had a friend yesterday that I was on or four of us doing an interview, kind of was interviewing them about something. And my friend Steven was saying some stuff that was really good. And I started to invite people. And then, so I heard about 25% of what he said. And then when I went back and looked at the video, I was like, I talked to him this morning. I was like, I'm so bummed out. I apologize because what you said in that time was huge. It was so important. I missed it.
Exactly. So I'm going to be here with you now. Is that Steven who went to my show? Event that I produced? How cool.
Yeah.
That's so cool. I love it also when online, offline things come together. Okay. There was something we mentioned right before we got on as well about something about how you knew you were going to be on video with me. And so you made a certain choice about what to eat last night.
Yeah. Well, not because I'm on video today, because tomorrow. Yeah. So I have an accountability conversation with Stephen Winter. He's the top real estate agent over at Whistle Realty and one of the top real estate agents in San Diego. And we do an accountability on Monday, and then we do a accountability on Friday. So we make our promises on Monday and we go over our promises on Friday. Okay. And then one of the things I put is like, I mean, on my accountability for Monday is I was going to do keto. I'm going to eat keto and I'm upping the amount of water intake. And then today I put, I've done keto pretty good, you know, blah, you know, kind of like that. But I've done good and all the different things I did, but I'm thinking about getting a pizza tonight. Like I really want a pizza tonight.
Yeah.
But I'm going to get keto this weekend. And he totally called me out on it. And when he did that, I said, okay, I need a reason. Like I need a reason better than I just feel like doing this. And I thought, oh God, I'm going to get trained tomorrow and I'm going to record 10 videos tomorrow. Like, and I want energy and I want to be focused and I want to be present. And if I eat pizza tonight, I'm going to be sluggish. I'm going to be bloated. I'm going to be all those things that I don't want to be. I'm going to have brain fog because of the flour, all that.
Yeah.
So I'm not, you know, so I have to prepare myself to be effective tomorrow.
Yeah. And that's so great. I wanted to bring that up because that's something I don't do as much on video, but it can help, but I do it for the stage. So this is about knowing your system, knowing what works for you, what gives you energy, what takes away from your energy. And I know that my digestion is pretty sluggish. I'm gluten intolerant, I'm dairy intolerant. So not that I don't have my pizza. I will have my pizza when I know I am not, exactly, I'm not gonna have to do anything that takes major brain power because I will go foggy brains. And when I'm on stage, I do not eat before I go on stage because I know I don't want my body to be digesting. I want all of my energy to be on stage with everybody and clear and focused. So I love that you brought that up because it really can help with video as well. Like, it's an opportunity for people to notice how they feel after they eat something. It's about being really conscious. So let's say you have oatmeal every day in the morning and you think it's a great, great thing to have for breakfast and healthy. And then you notice that you're foggy brained for some reason. Then you know that is not, first of all, it's probably not the best for your system, even though technically you think it is. And you know, if you got to shoot some videos and you have to be focused, that you eat something else, eat something with more protein or something like that. So that's a great little addition. And I also know that I used to do this when I was doing headshots and stuff like that. I'd make sure I wasn't eating anything that was going to make me feel bloated. I wouldn't have any kind of even cheese.
Yeah. We're so critical on ourselves. You know, why add to that? Why add, you know, that, you know, like, oh my God, I just ate, I feel sluggish, you know, and then I'm trying to work out of this, you know, it's like, forget that.
Well, and a lot of people, this is an exciting thing to work on for the weekend. You don't need this necessarily because you've done so many interviews and you interview people, but a lot of people, you know, are scared to do interviews because they're afraid they won't, like I met someone recently at a conference I was at, the last conference before we went into lockdown, who said she was really afraid, like she does live streams, she does videos, but she's really afraid to do an interview. And she really wants to do interviews because she's afraid she'll be tongue-tied and not know how to answer and stuff like that. And one simple thing that you can do, well, first of all, I work with people on their storytelling, breaks down, but one simple thing you can do is eat something that makes you feel clear and steady so that you're a good listener and then you're just replying to them.
That's great. Yeah.
So
that's good. I'm going to do that because I have not done that.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You haven't done what?
I haven't done like a pre-show prep.
Oh yeah.
There's things that I know that are really good. Like there's certain drinks that I can have that pop. And it's really funny because it is so basic and simple. But yet to be successful in life, it's not about doing one thing. It's about doing a lot of things habitually.
Habitually. That's the thing. It's the repetition and also knowing what works for you so that you do it each time. It's interesting. Rituals are really important. I didn't even realize until just now that I have such ritual for when I'm on stage more so than when I'm on video, but I've been, you know, sometimes you know all this stuff, you do it and you kind of throw it out because you've done it for so long. That's a great place to be in too. Okay. So you learned about how to present and there was something else it just slipped my mind. Oh, I wanted to share something. about lighting for people. So just know, everybody who's watching this, when you're in the group this weekend, I'm going to give you specific notes on you, where you are, what you're wearing, what's the best energy for you to bring. I don't make you dress like me, sound like me. I want you to be you. Like Martine was asking the other day, like, what characters should I learn or something like that? Yeah. It wasn't characters. And I was like, it's not you learn the New York type like I do. It's like learn, it's like get in touch with what who you are, and we'll bring that out. Something maybe that maybe this weekend we work on something that you've never shared in public, and we put it on video in the group to see if you're comfortable with it. But that would be really cool. People are craving connection and craving vulnerability. Yeah. Like this is your opportunity to do that and create real fans. So I was just going to say about lighting. So see, the lighting is so good right now on me. The light, this is about knowing what works, what doesn't work. So I'm pretty close to my window. My window is not exactly in front of me, but I like this backdrop the best. That's why, I mean, if I can do it a little bit that way or a little bit that way. But I do it this way because I'm a little closer to having the window in front of me. Right now I have, it's overcast, but I have shades down. Let me see if I can do this without, yeah. I have shades and I also have that down so that it creates this lighting. You would think that it's so overcast that I wouldn't need the shades or the blinds, but I do. So you wanna play with that. And what I was noticing is even going back here, while I like the composition of it being back, first of all, I'm smaller, so you don't see my face as much. And of course, this is gonna be much smaller when it's in on the video, but there's a place for like a medium shot, which is what this is. A long shot's when you have your whole body, and there's a place for it to be closer, but the lighting is not as good like this, right? When I come up, the lighting is much better. But I wanna sit right now, so it's knowing the rules and breaking them. And also, do you want to start with a longer shot? Or a lot of people want to kind of hide their bodies. So then you go closer, and that's fine. And then work on loving your body, because a lot of my stuff is about inner work as well. So what shall we do? I was saying yesterday, before we end, that we would maybe have you do a line or two, how you would do it from a video. And then I would give you direction on how to spice it up so that you could actually use it. Maybe even in the video that you're going to be doing or when you're going to be doing later or something like that.
Yeah, I unfortunately don't have my scripts with me right now. I don't have them. I left them somewhere. So,
okay. So it can be anything that you might want to talk about, or give me a topic that you think you're going to want to talk about.
Well, what I'll tell you a little bit about what the Focus 13 is the Focus 13 is.
That's the online course he's creating.
It came from my meditation practice that I do in the morning, every morning. And I meditate for 13 minutes. One morning I was looking at my day and I was overwhelmed with all the stuff I had to get done during the day, and realized that I'm probably not going to get it all done, because my experience of myself is not, I don't always get everything done.
Like 99% of the people.
Sure.
That's why this program is so good. Yeah.
And the reason that I don't get things done is because I'm very distracted. Like I get distracted very easily. And then I thought, well, I'm like literally kind of moving around going, well, if I can meditate for 13 minutes on my pillow, you know, I got my little pillow that I meditate on, my little meditation pillow. Right. I can meditate for 13 minutes on my pillow, and I do that every day. And I do that like no problem, very little resistance, and I just do it. Why can't I work for 13 minutes? Mm-hmm. So I said, all right, great. So what I did is I made a list, and then I just took everything I was going to do, and I said, I'm going to get that done in 13 minutes. And I got everything done on the list. I made another list, and I got everything done. By 12:30, I'd probably gotten a week's worth of work done.
Okay, I'm going to give some notes now.
Cool.
That's awesome. And it's wonderful just the way it is. And this is just for practice. This is how we rehearse, so that you can, if it works, what I'm sharing with you, you incorporate it when you're doing your communication. Yeah. Or sometimes you just get one moment that's like, oh, let me put that in there. This is what we as actresses do when we kind of like, we carve out like where the beat changes are in a sentence, where we're saying one thing and then we're going to another thought pattern and stuff like that. This is like all the homework we do. So then once we're on video or once we're on stage, we throw it all out, but we've done it. It's like our body remembers all the different choices we've had versus just saying something one way.
And I'd say for me, what I do as a sax player, I'll practice my scales, I'll practice the song. And when I hit the stage, whatever comes out, comes out.
Right, exactly. Yeah. But because you've practiced and you've done the scales or you've done exercises, something might surprise you on stage too, right?
Absolutely.
When you're in the moment. So that's what a lot of my work is. Like, how can you surprise yourself instead of just saying what you say always the same way that you say it? So
which is what I did. You know, that whole little thing I did became very kind of, to me, that's blasé. I'm trying to remember what I'm going to say and blah, blah, blah. I don't have my scripts in front of me or my teleprompter. So it becomes very, very clinical and very boring. There's no energy in it. Like, how do
you? Except what I'll say is that wasn't boring, because remember, it's boring to you because you know it. You've said it so many times. And as entrepreneurs, we do have to say the same thing over and over again. Yeah. But it's just like with my one woman show that I've done for over 12,000 people. I don't want it to be boring to me, because even though they're getting it for the first time, so it'll be interesting. I want every moment of my life to be filled with as much passion and excitement as I can have. And I want to learn something new. And even the words I've said a million times, if I start at the top, here's a trick. It's not exactly the same kind of exercise I'm about to give you, but when I do my show, my stage show, which I play like 12 characters in, for people who want to know a little more about that, I will say before the show, sometimes I want to learn something new about my family tonight. I literally set that intention before I go on stage, and usually I'll have an incredible new healing, even though I've done the show for as many years as I have. So another way to kind of create surprise would be before you do your video, you know, yes, definitely your why is important. Why are you saying this? But sometimes, even with acting, if I'm supposed to be doing a moment that really surprises me, and I think about something that happens in my life that really surprised me, one day that might not work anymore for me because I've said it so many times. So then I use something completely different. So it's the same thing. It's like setting an intention that's different from anything you've ever done. Like, you know what your why is. So then going, well, what could be something else that would be my intention today? Like healing and other things. Like, what if you did it for yourself? It's like, it's always supposed to be about the other person. But what I find the most fulfilled I am is like knowing if I reach one person with my message, then I've done my job, and it's about me completely fulfilling my life's purpose. So what if you're doing your recordings and you say, what can I learn about myself today while I share this with my potential client? How much more interesting will that be?
I love it. I love it. It's using curiosity too.
And using curiosity, which is your theory. Okay. So now I want you, we'll do it two different ways. One way is going to be a way, you saying something similar to what you just said.
Okay.
Focus 13. One way is going to be, I think probably one way you could do it, which is, I want you to say this, and somewhere inside the 1, 2, 3 sentences, you're surprised by what you say or what you're about to say. Okay?
Okay. So I've thought about this. Okay. So I was meditating, then all of a sudden, like that?
Yes! That's the acting tips that I give. How much more? Oh, wait until you see the recording. It's like you're in the moment instead of telling me what happened. You're showing me, which is an acting thing.
Yeah.
Great. Look at that. Okay. Now I want you to do it. And that was just a moment. Like, then you go through the whole thing and it just brings it alive beyond the words on the page. Okay. So now I want you to do it. This is the opposite of, but sometimes we do rehearsals and exercises to do the opposite, just to free our mind from saying the same thing over and over again in the same way. Mm-hmm. And sometimes there is something you use. I want you to say what you were saying with being frightened.
Say it again. I'm sorry, Heather.
Be frightened.
So say the same thing. So I was meditating, and then I realized something.
That was too similar to surprise. Okay. That's okay.
Surprise. Oh, I'm not good at
it. Like acting 101.
Okay.
And it doesn't have to be the same moment. It could be right after that.
Okay. So I was meditating, and then I realized something, and it really scared me.
Yeah, exactly. Oh my God. Wait until you see this. And then what you do, you rehearse like that. And then all of a sudden it comes to life. So now you build and you say, well, what worked? Oh, it really worked when I was like surprised. It really worked when I was frightened. You know what I'm saying? And it builds. And then people are watching and they're not even sure why they're so compelled, but they're compelled because something real is happening. And yesterday we talked about the difference, you know, like some entrepreneurs thinking or misinterpreting the word acting to be something phony or fake. It's the realest thing you can be, because I bet when you've discovered this, you were like, oh, instead of, and I discovered this and da, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you're not going to really add frightening or surprised where it doesn't go. You know?
Right. I mean, it's
going to be part of the expression. And that's what I didn't get.
Yes, exactly. However, that said, when you're rehearsing, sometimes this is an advanced technique, only for you don't have to do it, but and it's really great on stage because it makes it very exciting on stage. You might be rehearsing, and I might say, I want you to do the whole piece like you're frightened. So literally from the beginning, not even just from what you're saying, you're frightened. So what you would do in that situation is, in your mind's eye, you think of a time you were frightened, which is like, I'll think of right now, I was frightened when I was in New York City in my 20s and this man was following me. And then all of a sudden I'm telling you about this theory, focus 13, everything changes. My breathing changes, everything changes. I'm not saying that's right, but maybe there's a moment of that is right, because then it's at stake. Something's at stake. I have to tell you what's at stake. And then you have the lines that you're going to say on top of it.
Very cool.
I can't wait to have you this weekend.
Yeah. Great. I can't wait.
Awesome. Do you have any other questions?
What I want to say is one of the things I like, and I wrote it down, is that so many people teach context. They teach this like idea, this concept, you know, and, you know, like, it's almost like they're telling you what to do. And what I like about working with you is that you get the context, you get the, you know, the content, and it's like in the real work versus just, you know, just a theory or just a methodology. You know, let's actually dive into and train on the methodology. This is the theory. This is the methodology. This is how you act it out, and let's work on that. And that's what's really cool.
Thank you. Yes. Yeah. My aim is always for it to be experiential, so that you actually don't need me. Probably not good for my business, but you actually have the tools. You know how it feels, because you've experienced it. So you know how to go forward with it.
This is going to make such a big difference in all aspects of my life. So I appreciate it.
That's so great. So yes, please let people know. Anyone who's watching this, please let people know about this. It's super now. It's going to be $197 when we open it officially. This is like a beta weekend because it's the first weekend that I'm ever doing it. I want to help you get your videos in your made and made well. And I want to help you feel comfortable on video, on camera. It really does help with all aspects of your life as far as self-acceptance. I want this to be fun. That's the other thing. A lot of people are like, it's a drudgery to do videos. What if it could be fun? We're going to have fun this weekend, I promise you, because it's a big part of how I teach. Fun and fierce. So I got a lot of alliteration going on.
Awesome.
Fun and fierce. And the of course, now my phone's off. the link is in the Facebook page, and I will send this around to your friends, colleagues, family, because they'll learn something from this as well. It's very practical. I'm Brenda Adelman. Got any questions, let me know. But we're starting tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, inside our private Facebook group. I'm putting that together today. It's going to open about 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So everyone who's joined can go in there and start practicing. The other thing is, I give feedback on 3 videos this weekend. If you join this weekend for $97, you get into the weekend, next weekend that's starting. So it's another three videos, but inside the group, you can practice live streams in the privacy of the group. Like I won't be giving feedback on those, but you can practice and get better and use all the tools and techniques that you get from my four module program, You on Video, which is normally $600. It is bonus in for you. So you'll have all these techniques to practice. So it's really cool. I can't wait to watch everything. Thank you so much, Martine.
Thank you, Brenda. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, bye. Oh, I have to shut something. Let me.
Gotta hit a button.